Hello and welcome back to Tharic Plays Bastion. We are continuing with our playthrough, and we did the pipe here last time, which kind of surprised me, and I'm very happy though that I managed to beat that one. So yeah, that's basically it. So I hope it still counts, because there wasn't a story prompt or something like that afterwards. But let's see, I can buy some stuff here now in the Lost and Found that I've just built. So I don't really need those two right now. Upgrades for... this one is what I wanted to buy for
all
the...
all it takes is some fragments.
Breaker spell, a bow, as well as something heavy for Kalehammer. And then we can also buy some mementos here that are possibly going to tell us some stuff. Oh, we can actually buy spirits here as well for our upgrades. So what do we have here? Whale Ale, plus 25% damage using secret skills. Bastion Bourbon, health tonics fully restore health, plus 2 health tonic capacity. That sounds pretty amazing, actually. Lunghead Liquor, plus 100% damage when counterblocking with the bullhead shield. Probably not my strong suit. And Stab Synth, the name alone is amazing. Automatically retaliate when injured. I think I'm going to go for the Bastion Bourbon here. So let's restore that item. And I'm actually going to switch away from the Fetching Fizz because of that. And we're going to go for this one, just to keep myself a little bit safer. And next would be the Forge for some upgrades. So let's go for Kalehammer, I think. So what do we have here? Extended Grip to focus defend for a few moments using the bullhead shield, then attack. Or Reverse Grip, attack without moving to uppercut. Yeah, let's go
with
that one.
Ain't never letting go of his old friend with a sturdy grip like that.
That sounds pretty decent. And then we can go for the last upgrade on the Breaker's Bow. Plus 2 target penetrations per shot. I think I'm going to go for the increased draw speed.
His bow's looking lean and mean, like a prize fighter.
That just feels more useful to me right now. But I hope I'm not mistaken with that. So that's what we're going with here. And let's go towards the Skyway. Okay, what do I have available? Oh, we have the Scrapyard now. And the Zulwood Grove. So let's do a normal one for now, I think. So the Orchard here. And then we'll go for one of the training grounds and take a look at those.
No use praying to the gods these days. No time for it either.
So how? Okay, that's definitely a lot faster. That's pretty
Pit
nice.
Pit says a little prayer anyway. Couldn't hurt, right? Pith Orchard. Place is a dead end in more ways than one.
Okay. But my instincts were at least right. There is something.
Folks used
in
to
that
make
direction.
Pilgrimage here to pay their respects to Pith, the bull. Well, the gods are long gone now. And what? The Orchard Core.
Pith
long gone too.
The bull. So yeah, we did have that enemy, that bull enemy in the pipe. So maybe that's where we meet someone like this for the first
time.
It
stood for something once, something real.
So there was that way, the other way down there. So okay, yep, that's the optional path. So it's good to go here. Plush Pith.
The gods don't care about trinkets, but the kid ain't no god.
A memento, a machine-stitched likeness of the god of commotion and order. As the people of Selandia grew more self-reliant, they grew less fearful of their gods and turned them into commodities. Okay. So no enemies yet. It looks very green
in
and
time,
peaceful.
Though, the bull stopped being a symbol and started being decoration.
So, what do we have to expect here? That's very interesting about this game. I think that there
it
are
makes a decent scarecrow at least.
So many different ways of of so many different
then
levels. Oh, of course.
Like a rodeo.
So, my assumptions were right. This is where we meet these.
Ain't easy punching through his hide.
Oh, that's the uppercut?
The kid breaks into bits. Must have been guarding that shrine. So
okay.
What'll it be? Invoke the gods, or tell them off?
Oh, okay. So what do we have here? Pith. Foe shall grow quicker to move and to strike. Wait, so I have different gods here that I can invoke to make the game more difficult for myself, I guess? So foes shall grow quicker to move and to strike. The wakeful bull, patient yet temperamental, adorns. So let's
Pith.
Try that. So it gives us plus 10% XP and plus 10% of these. So I'm going to keep it like that.
To press his luck.
At least for this mission, to just see
well,
how
if
that
the gods
works.
Are alive, they must be plenty
or how manageable
strong.
That is. I do have more health tonics right now, and they do fill me up completely, so I'm probably okay with that. And if they drop like that, especially. Let me still try to keep my distance here.
Kid ain't never seen windbags that quick. Maybe old Pith put a scare in him.
Oh, the damage is pretty awesome, though. Let's see, there is that turret over there that I'd really like to shoot. Thank you. Oh, there's something coarse here. I missed that on the way in, or it just wasn't available at that point. Might be the case. So let's see. These are really not a big problem right now. Oh, hello. Yep, you're toast. So I do have a special breaker skill on that now, but not the one that I had before, a different one where the shot bounces. So we're going to try that out in a moment here. I'm just going to tank this guy for now.
Kid passes Pith's trial, and he's richer for it.
It's not that much damage to begin with, so I'm still good. Okay, we can't go there, so we probably need to go back where I went first, so where that closed gate was. That's probably where we can continue now. Okay, there's a flamethrower. Not anymore. I really like the Breaker's bow still. I think it's my favorite ranged weapon right now.
Kid ain't found a core, but at least he found Zulf's precious shrine.
Ah, okay, so there was no core here, maybe? And that just ends this? Looks like it. Okay, interesting.
Now we can build a shrine of our own, though I got some alternatives in mind.
Okay, that sounds ominous. Let's talk
Zulf
about the...
Zulf doesn't touch the thing.
The plush.
Says the god plush. Commotion is no children's toy.
So can I do something here? Steam bull. Apparently not, it's just the rumbling and sound. So what does Rocks have to
the
say Ura about this?
The Ura feared the gods. We turned them into toys. Put their faces on our walls.
Isn't he cute? Although I'm the button eyes do remind me of the movie Coraline, and that just still gives me nightmares because it's I don't know. If you've seen Coraline, you are perfectly aware of why I say that. Because that stuff is for nightmares. So let's go to the scrapyard.
That's the scrapyard. Where folks got to smash things and call it community service.
Because we do have some upgrades on Kalehammer already, so I think our chances of clearing that are a lot better. Depending on what we have to do here, we don't know that yet, of course.
The city's unwanted things all met their end in the yard.
Oh, do I just have to destroy all of this?
Folks who fouled up will do their time here, smashing things to bits.
Quickly destroy 100 objects. Okay.
The quicker they worked, the sooner they could go.
So let's go for that, and...
Folks learn to plant their feet and put their backs into it.
Let's see, so far this is going fairly quickly. We've destroyed a little over 50 objects by now. But we still have 50 to go, or 30 by now.
Others will plot a course to navigate that sea of junk.
But... I think the problem is getting everything in time. Oh, actually,
a good day smashing could feed a family for a week.
Oh, so the first two. Something heavy, that's nice, and something wrong. Okay, that sounds weird. Next prize, 27 seconds or less. Yeah, I'm not going to do that now. I just wanted to check it out.
Ever want to just smash things for a while? You know where to go.
Yeah, I do. And let's take a quick look here. Nothing at the arsenal, but maybe at the forge. So can I upgrade Kalehammer more? Yes. So more damage or plus 100% to critical hit damage. So I think I'm just going to go straight for the
Sail Hammer's only
straight up for more damage. Always.
That's a strong spine.
So that sounds pretty decent to me. And let's see. All we can do is continue on our path, I guess. Also, I've got the bullhead cord here as well now. But no, we're going to go Langston River now. And then we'll do some more Proving Ground stuff.
The Langston River flowed free and wild till the Calamity drank it all up. Maybe all that water just grew wings and flew off.
Okay, and we can destroy those. A little bit of stuff here. Okay, nice.
Riverbank swarming with windbags.
Yeah, but I don't really care about those. Especially if I've got my breaker's bow and can keep my distance.
Lucky for him, a certain famous ferry barge is still afloat.
Okay, so that's a story tidbit that we're not aware of yet. But how can I continue there? Oh, do I need to destroy this? Apparently I do. Switch. Oh.
Weeping Millie.
Hello.
She sends some squirts crying home as she leaves port. Maybe Nelly knows the way to the core.
Let's see.
Maybe she can slip right past all the clamor.
So
the
is
coast.
That thing we're on... He's talking about it like it's self-aware.
The security skiff pulls up portside.
So, now I don't understand that right now.
Those guns.
But, okay.
Just then, the windbags notice who she's sailing with.
Let's see. The breaker's bow really is... It's just amazing for these kinds of stuff. There's probably more spawning in.
They try to cut her off.
Not working. Go, Nelly. Even though it isn't your birthday, yeah.
They try to slow her down. They try to knock her out.
Still going strong here. So if they try, they fail. At least so far they do.
Well, Weepin' Nelly tries harder.
Yes, Weepin' Nelly, do your best.
Try as she might, though. She hits a snag.
Oh. Hello? Ah, okay.
He's gotta help her get untangled. Favors for favors.
Wait, what? How did I drop down there? Oh, that apparently was not something I could stand on. It's fine. Let's see. Nothing here for us yet. Oh, nice. I actually hit him without actually...
At least you picked a good spot for a break. The core is right there.
Wait, there is a health tonic down there, so I'm going to pick that up. Oh, nice. That I actually misclicked. I wanted to heal myself. Okay, the core is right there, so I'm just going to go the other way first and collect everything that is right here. Oh, I can just switch my arsenal there. Didn't want to do that, though. So let's see. Do I have to return to the Weeping Nelly after collecting the core, and then we're going to escape?
Then the kid hears an unusual sound, like 100 flapping wings.
They have
their own eyes on the core. Why?
Wow, what's going on?
He finds Weeping Nelly raring to go. Turns out she's got a special surprise for when the waters get rough.
Nice! So these turrets are on my side. I think. Yeah, they're charmed. So let's see.
She's gonna need a little help with all them peggers. Drafted things think they're king of the roost now. Rest of us only wish we could fly in times like these.
Still pretty... going pretty well so far. Where are they coming from? Over there. Already shut down. So what are these birds things? I think Rux said something about them, but I was too...
Securitas gifts keep on coming.
I was too occupied with escaping at that moment. Shoot, long as they hit something. Why are the gas fellas still coming at us as well? We have no trouble with them. Well, that's not true, but you know what I mean.
The windbag's getting even better idea. They aim to smash Weeping Nelly to splinters.
Well, oh, I fell down.
Too much for poor Nelly.
Let's see. Oh, Nelly is going down? What's happening? We're speeding up, which is worrisome.
She's just gotta make one last stop.
Yeah, please don't kill me or anything. Ow.
Last breath. Nelly gets the kid to solid ground.
Ooh.
Solid ground and Pekka country. They want that core real bad.
Pekkas, okay.
Seems
that's what they're
called. Calamity ain't hurt the Pekkas' appetites. Kid shoos them off, knowing they'll be back.
Goodbye.
Know how many times kid nearly fell off the barge back there?
Yeah, a lot of times.
Three times.
Three? Okay. It sounds like a rhetorical question and then he answers it. That's weird.
Now, listen close. You should remember this next part.
That's so weird. I like
Why
it.
Why go to Prosper Bluff?
Okay, this is still going on. Interesting. This is one of the longer levels again.
Used to take an enterprising man or a plain old fool to venture out that far.
Yeah, apparently I'm an enterprising fool, I guess. I can't go this way, so we need to go that way.
The city was the most beautiful place in the world. We all knew that.
I assume that it's going to
but
open
on the
that
other
up.
Hand, some folks just yearn to see the things they're told they can't.
Oh, what the hell?
Then that's why you go to Prosper Bluff, ain't it?
The Breakers shows a passing skill with the Breakers, but oh! I managed that one now. Although I think I should have managed that one last time already. But I'm not complaining. So this is pretty nice. I don't like these small planks, though.
There, the kid hears something he ain't heard in a long while.
Oh, and what is that? Oh!
How's it go again?
Why did that happen? I don't know. Ah, okay, so that skybridge just puts me back over there. I assumed it would end the level.
Yeah.
Oh, it's
that's
a song?
The
one? Sounds like a song. Oh, they got ranged attacks now. Anything I can do here? I don't really want to drop down there. Okay, so apparently not. At least not yet. That's pretty interesting. So, it's just this weird world with the Calamity, and now there's the music playing. It's a little bit quiet. But it's a pretty weird offset because it's really harmonic. Let's wait for that to evaporate. Let me actually increase the music volume a little bit. Hope it's... Yeah, I think that's better. And I'm just listening right now. And I hope you can understand why. It's a nice contrast. I don't completely understand it, once again, but who cares? It's really interesting right now. I like this a lot because it's just such a difference to the tone that the level itself is setting right now, and the narrator, Sorux, is not saying anything right now. He's just letting the music run without interrupting. That's a really nice touch. So how long will this go on? I mean, we are moving steadily forward. So how long will this continue? What is there? I think we don't need to go that way at the moment. Well, let's see, because we can activate that over there. So no, that's a skybridge, so I definitely need to press the button over there first. So let's do that. Wait. Okay, that puts me back up here, so I could have gone two ways, or is this just optional? I think it might be. Yeah, it looks like it was meant for us to get that health tonic, but we weren't necessarily needed to do that. Oh, you guys are annoying. And defending here would probably be better, but I don't get used to that for some reason. I always forget about being able to do that. Okay, we need to go this way. I still don't really understand the significance of that song, but I don't really care. It's still, once I can only repeat myself with here, with the contrast that it sets. I like it. I can say that much. Even though,
well,
I don't fully understand
no point
it.
Explaining what happens next, right?
I still like it. So it's this.
Suffice it to say, kid ain't coming home empty-handed.
We do have that core. So what is this? A memento, a worn book handwritten in the traditional Yura script. Amid the scrawled notes, the book contains various indecipherable scientific diagrams, drawings, and mathematical formulae. Okay.
And besides, it's like the song goes. Be here before too long. We darn near celebrated when the kid got back, didn't we? Zolf never thought he'd see a fellow Ura again. We become fast friends. Calamity has that effect on people. But there was more to be done. There was one last core to find.
Just one? That can't be all, surely? But wow, okay. Let's put in the core for
Kid's
the money.
Surprised when I tell him there's only one core left. I shouldn't have believed it either.
This game has an amazing ability to just know what I'm saying. Or just... It's so weird, but it's pretty amazing. I don't fully understand it, but I'm not complaining. Once again, so we can build the shrine here. And
behold, the pantheon.
So we can invoke those before now. So we've got Akobi here, Goddess of Oath and Abandon. Foes shall have vengeance in the throes of defeat. No one bound the chastened maid save for herself. Her shackles are her own design. Okay, so we'll leave that for now. So let's talk with Rux first.
If only I'd known half the secrets of the Calamity were tucked away in that book, I'd have worked a translator right away.
Oh, okay. That's a little bit of nice insight.
A scientific journal written in Zulf's native tongue. He learned so much from it. Too much.
And let's see what the singer has to say, Zia.
Most of the Ura never got a taste of Ceylandia's fine goods, unless they were born and raised in the city like Zia here. Girl tried to run away from home one time, but the marshals stopped that, didn't they? So many secrets in there, and she can't even read it. Her father's own journal.
Oh, okay, so she can't read? We finished one here.
The Breakers. Ain't no one could outrun them. Or their arrows.
I agree. So, what next? I'm still a bit... The last level did have a pretty an impact on me for some reason. I don't know. It's the music and just the contrast of Rux not saying anything.
We tracked the final core beyond the city to the wilds.
That was pretty interesting. So I'm not going to play the Wild Outskirts right now. We'll leave that for the next mission. Or not the next mission, for the next video, but we're going to check out the Zulwood Grove Proving Ground now, I think.
Ever felt a Zulwood gourd? Like picking up broken glass barehanded.
The question is, Zulwood Grove, what do we need to
marshals
do
learn
here?
To make every shot count.
Ah, so it's once again doing the least amount of shots.
The trick was to pop all those nasty gourds without wasting ammo. Most marshals didn't get far on their first few tries.
So let's try this. So...
had to catch a bunch of those gourds in a single shot.
Let's see. Those are all gone.
Funny thing about muskets is they work best up close. The best of the best clear the course in just a few shots.
Let's see how many did I get. Oh, what? I actually managed to get all of it in the first time around? What? That's surprising. That really is surprising. I wouldn't have thought that possible. I'm happy though. That's pretty awesome. So let's go to the Skyway.
Kid probably could have made himself marshal one day.
Yeah, apparently. And let's check on the forge. So what do I have in terms of upgrades here? So I can upgrade the musket twice, the fang repeater twice, and then there's still a lot of stuff that I can't upgrade yet. So we'll have to wait for the weapons there. So we should still be very far away from finishing. The last core is a little bit of a trick, I assume. But we'll see. So before we end the episode, let's go for the bullhead court. I would like to see what's up with that as well.
The accused always got a fair shake in Ceylandia. Some used to take the bullhead trial.
Deflect attacks without getting hit.
Survive the trial without taking a scratch, you'd walk away a free man.
So do I just have to reflect that? So how do I reflect those? Let's see, and this is... Let's see. Ah, okay, with the counter it works a lot better. So let's try to get a counter hit again. Okay, nice. Oh. Oh, they are. Yeah, I definitely need to get the counter hit.
Bullhead trial taught folks three things. First, a good defense is a good offense.
That's second, pretty awesome that you get back. To third, just learn this.
No godlike bull up there gonna save you.
Hello. No, okay, I need to wait here. That's still too early. Still too early. Oh god, that's... It's not a tad more difficult. I just don't want to screw this up. So I apologize if this is taking a little bit longer. There it was. Okay, one more. So he's taking the same amount of time. That one did work better. Oh. Oh crap, I got hit. There's a counter. So I got hit twice so far. Still pretty good average, I think, although I probably need to make this work without getting hit to begin with. To get all of them. Oh, really? Squirts? Countering them is pretty okay so far. Okay, so how long does this go? How does he attack? Oh, now they vary, which is a bit annoying. Oh, really? That's pretty nasty. So let's try to get rid of those first. Oh, come on, yeah. Okay. Was that it?
The smarter ones knew when to just step aside and let things go.
Oh, okay. That's a little bit of a hint, I guess. So let's go over here. Come on, buddy. Follow me, please. Oh, I actually did counter there by accident. Another counter. Another counter. Okay, they can't actually fall off. That's, I assume, what this meant. So I've taken 12 hits by now, so I doubt you'll have
to... The kid pulls through in fine form.
You have to get... Don't get hit at all for this to work. But I don't know. Next prize, 3 hits or fewer. Wow. That's quite the difference. With 12,
kid always wanted to compete in the bullhead trial.
Still got twice. I got 2 prizes. So that's still fine here now, I think. So this is where we're going to end the episode for today. I like those 2 proving grounds. They were pretty nice. And maybe I'll get better at countering from now on. But we'll see. So, yeah. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please leave a like and a comment. And if you want to see me play more Bastion, just subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, thanks for watching. I hope that you tune in next time and have a nice day. Bye.